Hi, I'm Jim Conroy, and I love and support Film Academy 360. I grew up watching Sesame Street, Electric Company, Romper Room, Mr. Rogers. I used to love all the Hanna-Barbera cartoons, Bugs Bunny, Roadrunner, Daffy Duck, Droopy Dog, all the Tex Avery stuff, Mel Blanc. So, you know, when you're a child of the 70s, you're growing up on television. I love these characters, and when you're watching cartoons and you're watching animated movies, you memorize them, you start doing the voices, you have all the toys, you're reenacting everything. You're reenacting Star Wars, you're reenacting Marvel. That's just part of the experience. You're like, I'd love to do that, but you don't really know what it is when you're a kid. And at some point, you realize that Bugs Bunny is not Bugs Bunny. Bugs Bunny is drawn, and there's somebody standing in front of a microphone that's doing the voice. And once I realized that that's a person doing that, it wasn't just something that existed, like you draw it and the sound was there. I wasn't a very smart kid. Once you realize that that's something that somebody could do, that's when I knew I wanted to do that. As a kid, I didn't know how I was supposed to go about doing that. My parents didn't know how they were supposed to guide me into doing that. They just all thought it was silly, as parents should. I knew that that's what I wanted to do, and so when I went to college, I studied acting, just hoping to gain enough skills to try to break into the voiceover market, and I moved down to New York City in 1997. It took me about 4 years to get an agent, another 2 years after that to book my first cartoon, and 18 to 20 years after that to start working with the great animators and production companies out of Los Angeles. So I knew pretty young, certainly under the age of 10, that this is what I wanted to do. I just had no idea how to go about doing it. Took a lot longer to figure that out.